Mr. Wayne Brady. What's going on, Wayne?
Hello, hello, hello.
Hey, man.
What's up, family?
You had me grooving right there with that little clip from Let's Make a Deal, Primetime Player. So how are you taking it next level, Primetime?
Why reinvent the wheel? What we've done with our Primetime show is we're introducing it to the audience that maybe doesn't get a chance to see the crazy party that the daytime show is,
right,
with bigger prizes. Tons of cash, big cars, guest stars like my man Chris Jackson, who is on CBS on Bull, but also is the original Washington in Hamilton, and
ooh,
is one of my best friends.
Oh, nice.
So we're trying to hip the world to the party that Let's Make a Deal is. It's not just a game show. It's a variety show. It's an improv show. It's a sketch show. It's just plain fun.
It's a feeling. I love tuning in. And Wayne, last time we touched base with you, you were quarantining with your ex-wife and her boyfriend and your daughter. How's that going?
Hmm. Yes. Well, you say like, how's that going? There's got to be shenanigans. No, it's our regular life. There are lots of couples that you don't read about that happen to be really close. Mandy's my ex-wife. We've known each other for 20 odd years. And in this time of a bubble, her boyfriend come over to my place because we live 2 minutes away from each other, and we quarantine together with our daughter. So it's been natural for us. We didn't need a quarantine to do that. We've been doing this for Miley's whole life, but we're just hipping the rest of the world to it. And now we have a sitcom that we're working on with our friends who were the showrunners over at Will and Grace, Tracy and John. We're writing a script about, you know, a life as a blended family. We call ourselves the Core Four.
I love that. That's what it should be.
That's so funny. And talk about, life imitating art, I guess, in this case. And I think it says a lot about you, man, that, you know what I mean? You get along with the ex well, and things are obviously better than just cordial and taking co-parenting to the next level right there. So the premise of the show, is it specifically based on your exact family? Are you going to be using, like, the same names? Are you going to modify it a little bit? Or how will it be different?
It's kind of Curb Your Enthusiasm-ish. It's based on our family.
Oh, got
it. So it'll be our family playing our family, but then with heightened stories,
yes,
and all those other things.
Oh, fun.
Just kind of showing the dynamic.
Now, your daughter's a teenager. How's dating going? Take it out before quarantine. How are you handling all of that?
It's a natural part of life. I thought that for years, you know, when people come up to you and say, uh-oh, she's a pretty one, you better get a shotgun. At first I thought, oh yeah, maybe I will handle it, you know, the bad boys way with Will and Martin when the guy comes up to the door. Then you end up intimidating him. You want to date who? But then I thought about it and I read these amazing words someplace that said, if I've raised my daughter the right way and instilled a great sense of self in her, then why would I be worried? I should trust the fact that she is going to follow in these footsteps that I've laid as a father and her mother has laid as a mom, and the two of us working wonder twin powers in tandem to raise her.
That's awesome to hear, and the logic sounds solid. But at the same time, I got to give them that death debt, that little dad stare, just so they know what's up. That dad doesn't play.
Oh yeah, he has to know that. I mean, upon entering the house, you give a nice firm handshake, but now in the COVID era, it's like I bump his elbow just a little harder than needed.
Right.
I'm like, but welcome to my house. And now we're good. And he walks around going, damn, Mr. Brady. So he knows what's up.
I respect that. Cool.
I like that. I think my dad would counsel the guys, like, buckle up if you're taking kid out.
Right.
I think it was that way. Tell us about the show you're hosting, Puppy Best in Show. We love anything involving puppies.
Me too. You guys know from your years in the business, anytime that something that you genuinely love can intersect with the business piece that you get asked to do and you're paid for it, it's a job, it's a perfect thing. I love dogs. I have four dogs, as you can see in some of my TikToks, because my TikTok game is strong. I have four dogs of my own, two Rotties, a Bichon Frise, and a Tibetan Terrier.
Wow.
So,
all over the place.
So... And then Mandy has three dogs, so we have a pack of seven.
You got a kennel.
I love dogs. So Kanan reached out to me and said, hey, would you host this pre-show with the puppies? And I said, of course, you're going to pay me to hang out with puppies? Done deal. So I'm hosting the pre-show, and the pre-show is amazing because we're also going to be doing this contest that people can send in their videos, and you send in your puppy videos, and if we pick your video as the best in show, we give you $5,000. Plus, a year's supply of Canaan puppy chow.
Hey, I got a puppy right now. Right. Really cute. Little Oscar.
Really cute.
I might come up.
A little Frenchie.
I'm going to submit.
Oscar. Ooh, a Frenchie too?
Yeah.
Put Oscar in the video. Put Oscar in the video.
That's what's up. All right.
$5,000 for just taking a video of your puppy. And at the end of the day, they're also doing a lot to educate new puppy owners during the pre-show, because we all know those people that see a movie and go, oh my God, I want a Dalmatian now. Mm-hmm. And as soon as the movie's finished,
right,
they have a dog on their hand that has now grown from a puppy into a dog. And they're like, oh, I can't do this. Royal Canin is all about dog adoption and puppy safety and rescues. So that's why I signed on board, and I'm so glad to be on the team.
Well, right, Wayne, on, we're, man, so glad we got to see you. Best of luck with everything. We're so excited about your new show, the sitcom about your life, too. And
congrats,
let's,
Wayne,
make a,
we'll,
deal. Primetime special airs on December 22nd on CBS at 9, 8 central.